everyone, welcome to another episode of Pia's Postcards. And as you can see, I am in sunny Dubai. And we are in the Souk Madinat. Souk means market, so this place is like the modern take of a market. And we'll be going around and I'll be interviewing another global Filipino, and his name is Furne One. We take you to the city of gold, Dubai. Dubai is known for luxury shopping, ultra-modern architecture, and a lively nightlife scene, and I'm very excited to experience all these and more with you. Dubai has been a trailblazer in design and extravagance all over the world. More than anything, I have always been amazed by how fashion-forward this country is, and what's really interesting is that we have our very own designers setting the stage of Dubai. For this episode, we're going to meet the one and only Furne One. It's not my first time in Dubai. I've been here before when I was Miss Universe, so this is actually my second time. And now we're here at the Souk Madinat. It's so nice here. Oh my gosh! Ayan na! Wow! I need to take a selfie. It's so pretty. It's so nice. It's really so beautiful. This is one activity that I'm really enjoying. So after this boat ride, we'll be heading to the Dubai Mall, and then we'll be meeting our fellow Filipinos there for a meet and greet with Philipstyle. In fact, I'm wearing one of their watches now. I'm sure to have a lovely trip tomorrow with Furne One, but for today, we're going to the Dubai Mall right now to meet Will Stein and do a quick meet and greet with the Filipino community. So I'm really excited. It's not my first time to meet Will Stein. I met him when I was launched as the new endorser for Philipstyle in Manila. But it's nice that I get to see him again, but this time in a different country. I love the weather. The weather's really nice. I hope it doesn't get too hot though. The food's amazing here. In fact, I just had some lamb curry before coming down, so it was so good. And I also love how diverse Dubai is. I think almost everyone from everywhere is here. So it's really a melting pot. I really love that about Dubai. There's really so much to see. I'm really excited.
To have you here in Dubai. Welcome.
I'm so happy. Thank you so much.
And congratulations on your movie.
Thank you so much. Yes, I'm showing
I follow you on Instagram. I see all these posts. Fantastic.
Oh, thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
So tell me about this show which you're doing, this travel show. So you came here to Dubai to...
So every episode we go to different places in the Philippines.
Okay.
And around the world.
Okay.
And then we tour around, the camera follows me around. In fact, they're here now. Hi,
okay.
Say hi.
Hi.
So and then we also interview some Filipinos from those places that have made it there.
Okay.
So like world-renowned or recognized Filipinos from that place. So we did.
And who are you going to interview here?
Furne One.
Fashion designer.
Yeah. So we did Cebu already. We did New York. And then now we're doing Dubai. And we're going international so quickly. Imagine from Cebu to Dubai right away on our third episode.
That's why you need a watch which helps you relax,
exactly.
Right?
Exactly.
And the rest of it.
Yeah, I have it already in Dubai and Manila time. Hi, guys. Hello.
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 So welcome to the Watch House. The Watch House is actually a store owned by our distributor, Al-Futtaim, here in Dubai. And there are 12 Watch Houses, and you're in the Watch House in the Dubai Mall.
Nice.
Where we have, of course, the Philip Stein brand, which I want to show you here.
Okay.
So, of course, just like in the Philippines, you know, one of our most popular watches is the dual time zone. This is what Philip Stein is known for. This is what Philip Stein started with. And but we also have, of course, other models. And in fact, we have one model here on your wrist because it's a very feminine watch. You can see how beautiful it also. It's one of our most popular models.
My personal favorite is the one with the dual time.
With the dual time.
Because it helps me find out the time where I am and the time back home.
It's really perfect for people like you who travel constantly, and you know, I travel constantly. And there are many other people who do, you know, have this kind of schedule.
Whenever I travel, I have the time wherever I am and the time back home. So
that's
I'm
right.
Always connected to people I'm with and people who are
exactly.
And my loved ones back home.
Exactly. So what we prepared here is a little event, you know, because of course here in Dubai, this is one of the places where you have outside of the Philippines, the most Filipinos in the world. So it's a big community. So I think you're going to be surprised how many people will gather here today, because they want to see the icon of the Philippines, you know, Pia Wurtzbach.
Yes.
So we are very, very happy to have you here.
Thank you so much.
Let's go over here. People who exercise, who are active, you know, who need to have focus, who need to be alert, who need to have energy, this is the perfect product for them. Do you exercise?
I exercise, but I've never...
You've never tried that?
No, I've never tried that. It's weird.
Okay, so then we have to give you one.
I only have to tell Sir Will, I don't have that yet, and then right away, I get it. Just kidding.
It's like genie in the bottle.
Yeah. Maganda yung white, diba? Tama naman ako sa choice.
So this year, what's nice about it is it's natural rubber and it's hypoallergenic. So you don't, you know, even if you have an allergy to silicone or something, you can wear it. And look how beautiful it looks. It's also something you would go out with, right?
Yeah. And then I would be very energetic
then
in
very
the club.
Very energetic in the club. Yeah.
It's the energy.
So that's for you.
This is mine?
Yes.
Oh, great. Thank you so much. See? I got my, what is this called to be exact?
Horizon Sport.
Horizon Sport in Dubai.
It was a great event with Philip Stein today, but I need to get some rest since we have a fun-filled day tomorrow. I can't wait to meet Furne One, and I'm really excited to see his design.
Welcome to Dubai.
Thank you.
We're so stunning all the time. Furne just flew in from Italy, and I'm going to take you now to his ateliers in Vitry.
Okay, cool. Let's go.
He has dressed so many celebrities, and he's the designer of the dress. All the royalties here, especially the daughter of the president. Did that. And then he's really excited to meet you.
Oh.
It's amazing that you're going to meet. No.
I'm excited.
An internationally renowned and multi-awarded designer with his decades of breathtaking collections, his brand Amato, which means beloved, certainly epitomized his designs, which would really make you fall in love in each pieces. One of Dubai's leading fashion designer, Furne Amato One.
Pia. Welcome to Dubai.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Welcome to Amato.
And thank you for making time for me because I know you're very busy and you flew in from all these different places.
Likewise. Also, you, I know you're so busy.
But I'm glad that our schedules are able to meet and then now we're finally here. So I'm just going to ask you like a few questions. I'm very curious. It's my first time to see all of this and you. So I just want to know, like, how would you describe an Amato woman?
For me, an Amato woman is a woman who's not afraid of the dictates of fashion.
I like that.
She wants to experiment.
Mm-hmm.
She's not, you know, like in a box.
I see. And I know that you're based here in Dubai and most of your work is really here. What made you choose Dubai out of all the cities?
I used to work with apprentice with Josie Natori in New York, mm-hmm. and it's a great learning process for me. And my friend told me, how about drop by Dubai? And then when I'm here, there's a lot of things to learn.
Mm-hmm.
All the workers, the beaders, all the artisans. So it makes me, you know, like think that I should be here because I love embellishment, I love texturizing, I love, you know. So this is me.
So upon your first visit, you fell in love with Dubai right away?
Yes.
I see.
It's like a calling.
I see. And I was curious, why Amato?
Why Amato? Amato is Italian for beloved.
Yeah,
so the first plan is to make like all bridal.
Okay.
Yeah, and then we venture into party dresses. And now we open this prêt-à-porter line just mm-hmm. last year.
Mm-hmm. And I know that you have another store like nearby.
Yeah.
Dutaas, so yeah. Hopefully we'll be able to look at that also. So now we're here, we're looking at the gowns and everything. And I know that you have almost all the colors available.
Pastels,
yeah. Yes. And
for this season, it's a lot of pastels. Mm-hmm. It's like French macaroons.
Yeah, it does remind me of that actually, now that you mentioned it. I want to know, like, where do you draw inspiration from?
Number one, I love movies.
Okay.
I love architecture.
Mm-hmm.
My trips, my travel, the culture.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of things to be inspired. I love life.
Okay, so that's where you get your
inspiration
from.
Yeah.
And that's constant, no? Like, from everywhere you go, from wherever you travel, whatever you experience. Yeah. You're a globally renowned Filipino living here in Dubai and you've made it here. You're very successful here, but I know you're still very close to your Filipino roots. Can you tell us more about that?
Number one, I employ lots of Filipinos.
Okay.
Yeah. Second is, as a Filipino, we are blessed that we have lots of culture.
Mm-hmm.
Like we have the Spanish, we have the we have lots of influences, mm-hmm. and it helps.
Mm-hmm.
It helps you grow as a designer.
So you're from Cebu, right?
Cebu.
So you're from Cebu, and do you still go back home?
Yeah.
Okay. Every year?
Oh, not yearly.
Not yearly. So you're really based
because
here.
My family is based now in Chicago and LA.
I see. But almost all of your employees are Filipino.
Almost,
and,
yeah.
And you're very close to the Filipino community here.
Of course.
Can we talk about this piece right here?
Okay, this piece is my finale piece for Fashion Forward. I don't know, season 7 or 8.
Mm-hmm.
It's my Immaculate Virgin Mary.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think, yeah, now I see it because then I see that and it all makes sense, right? So, I've seen all of your beautiful dresses, the beautiful gowns here. And I was wondering, would you let me try one of your gowns?
Of course, I'll one for you. I think this one.
Oh, wow. Okay, let's do it. Yes. Okay.
Looks good.
I love it. I love how it fits me. I love the color. I love how feminine it is. It makes me feel like a queen. I like that
every dress is unique, and I love how delicate it is. It's very feminine. I love the fabric.
And it's not heavy.
It's not heavy, yeah. Like, you can move around. Like, if you were out in a social, like, setting, it wouldn't be hard for you to move around and socialize and talk to people. Like, magaan. Like, it's... Like, how it looks. It looks light and it feels light also.
Spring.
Spring is the inspiration, yeah. I love that it's very...
Because when I went to Versailles, you know, I was so inspired with the palace.
Ah, I see.
So it's spring, Versailles, fresh, young.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Very young and regal. The dresses are so beautiful. I had a hard time picking out a favorite, and I could not pick one dress. But he pulled out a dress for me, and I said, all right, let's try it. It looks so beautiful. You can see that there's a lot of hard work put into making the gowns. The piece was heavenly. I really felt like a queen with the extraordinary details and elegance that it brings. I felt like a true Amato woman. So, thank you very much for letting me try on your beautiful dress. I really appreciate it. It's so beautiful. Mm-hmm. And I know that it was done with love. Probably took so long for it to be made. But thank you. Ang ganda! Oh my God! Can I?
Yeah, sure.
Ah! It's so pretty. It's not pretty. It's beautiful. That's the word.
This is my latest collection, the couture version of the Versailles gown. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is the couture version.
You know, when I looked at the gowns earlier, I thought they were beautiful already, but this just tops it off. Like, I thought I've seen it all, like that was the most beautiful already, but this is even more beautiful. Like, the queen in me, the pageant queen in me has risen. I am so speechless. Pagpasa ko talaga, hindi ko alam kung ano yung una kong titingnan. The gowns earlier were beautiful, and they were beautiful. I mean, I wore one of them. Galing. Look at this! Ang powerful, oh! Each one of them gives you a different kind of confidence. Some can, like, make you feel more... Some can make you feel more confident, some can make you feel more empowered. Look at this. Kaya ko tong suotin, guys. I can wear this. And this. Look at that. So nice. Just, so pretty. I was really impressed with his store downstairs when we saw the RTW collection, but then when I stepped in to see the couture collection, I was blown away. Furne, tell us about your childhood in Cebu.
I grew up in Cebu, and I took a fine arts major in advertising, mm-hmm. because that time there's no fashion school.
Ah, so how did that help out with your transition to fashion now?
There's subjects.
Ah, okay, so you were still
able... We have
able...
like fashion designing, textile designing, accessories.
So you were still able to apply it now. And then Did you take up any further education on fashion after that?
When I won the grand prize. Mm. So my prize is to go to Paris to see the real fashion industry. Mm-hmm. And to go to New York.
Wow.
That time I took up short courses in FIT.
Oh, so it really was just that you taking risks, like joining a contest and then
of course.
Doing short courses. So what would you say are your milestones in your career? From the top of your head.
There's a lot of highlights.
Okay.
Like number one, working with Heidi Klum.
Mm.
In her Germany's Next Top Model. Mm. And it opened doors for me because Germany's Top Model is a huge thing in Europe, in Germany.
Mm-hmm.
And she's bringing talent like Katy Perry. And then I met Katy Perry.
Mm.
And it opened doors for me. Then I designed her tour, mm-hmm. concert outfit.
Yeah.
The California Dream Tour.
Mm-hmm.
Some stylists in LA, I've seen the dresses, so they contacted me, and then it opened doors to Nicki Minaj, Beyonce, Shakira, a lot.
Wow, that's mm-hmm. that's really amazing. And being a global Filipino working here in Dubai, what were some of your challenges naman?
It's difficult because number one, I'm not from here.
Mm.
Number one is to open a shop. I'm just so blessed and lucky that I met my business partner,
mm.
Rashid. He's into textile, and then he told me how about we open a shop, and then that's it.
That's how it all started.
Yeah.
But it probably like took you some more other challenges before you
of
got
course.
To that point. What would your advice be for like Filipinos who OFWs, to be more specific, that are living here, that are still trying, because you're already very successful.
Focus, and aside from hard work, kasi kailangan talaga hard work.
Yeah.
Determination, kailangan, you should have a vision.
Mm-hmm.
For me, that's very important. Because if you have the vision, you know the way.
Mm-hmm.
Meron ng path.
Yeah.
Kasi kung wala kang vision, so pagganin-ganin ka.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I think Filipinos are, parang they adapt easily.
Mm-hmm.
Number one, they adapt and they're very flexible.
Mm-hmm.
I think to be successful in this business, you have to be flexible.
Mm. And it's also very important that they like what they're doing, no? And that they love their careers, they love what they're doing, so they don't feel like burned out, especially living so far. Do you ever get homesick?
Sometimes, yeah.
Sometimes?
Yeah.
But you go home.
Because I'm so focused with work.
Ah, I see.
So there's no time to think about sometimes home.
Mm-hmm.
During Christmas,
yeah.
Holidays. I think it's every designer's dream to dress up beauty queens, celebrities, artists.
There are no words to describe the pieces Furne let me try. And I'm so thankful even more that he gave me one of his pieces to wear for a prestigious event. I'll definitely be confidently beautiful with a beloved heart there. Furne, thank you so much for showing me around here and showing me your breathtaking creations. They're so beautiful. And especially thank you for lending me some gowns for Binibini Pilipinas. I really appreciate it. Thank you so much. So now, we're off to lunch, and it's one of your favorite spots. It's called
Harper's Bazaar.
Harper's Bazaar. Let's go.
This one is the fashion district.
This is the fashion district of Dubai. It's like the meatpacking district of New York. And
all the meatpacking also are here. Okay. Furniture, designer, accessory designer.
I just saw it outside, so I'm gonna try it. Wait, I need to secure my dress. Yeah, okay?
One, video yan.
Video.
One,
two, three.
Oh.
Oh my God!
Oh, God.
staple food here? Like when you think of Dubai, that's the first thing you think about. Yung food na yun. What do you think it is?
Actually, it's mixed.
Mm, it's a lot.
Oh, kasi Arabic, merong Lebanese, merong here, mm-hmm. meron din Egyptian food. Mm. So, maraming Arabic food.
Do you have a favorite?
Patush, yung meat salad nila.
Ah, I see. And what about Filipino food? Do you miss Filipino food?
No.
You don't?
No, because all the time I'm eating Filipino food.
At home? What do you usually ask them to cook for you?
Lahat, like lechon kawali, adobo.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so now we're going to visit the Philippine consulate. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's go.
So let's go.
We are going to the Philippine consulate to meet some Filipinos there. And then we're going to talk to Furne more about his relationship with the Filipinos, especially the OFW. How's the Filipino community here in Dubai?
Actually, there's a lot of Filipino community here in Dubai. And that's why I'm bringing you to the consulate for your courtesy call.
Furne has been a pillar of hope in the Filipino community as a whole in Dubai. I hope my short time there also brought moral support to our fellow Filipinos sacrificing for their families back home. This place to where we were earlier?
This one is the old Dubai.
Okay.
Where they started everything. The trade started here.
Okay. So I can see that there are a lot of jewelry
gold.
Here.
This one
yeah.
is full of jewelry, gold, because Dubai is one of the trade here is gold in the Middle East, aside from oil.
So how is Dubai different now from when you first came here?
Big difference.
Big difference?
Big. Before it was more little shops, while now it's more global.
Mm-hmm. So that's the biggest difference.
Yeah,
so.
That's the biggest
But would difference. You still say that this area of Dubai is still very much booming?
Yes, because they preserve the culture, because this is one of the tourist spot here.
Ah, I see. Yeah, and still there are still very much a lot of tourists around. Okay, let's go.
Okay.
What a beautiful spot you picked for us, because now we have the view of this iconic
iconic building right here. Yeah. Is this one of your favorite spots?
One of my favorite. This hotel, before, there's no Burj I used to, I always come to this hotel.
Ah, I see.
Because this is the only, like, five-star hotel before, before the Palm.
Before all of the other places, this place was here already. How often do you come here?
Before, every weekend.
Every weekend? Really? Yeah. So this place is really happening.
Before, but now I always go to different hotels just to eat.
Yeah, yeah, just to experience each one.
Because I love eating. I like to experience all the, you know, hotels. So I'll take you later to Burj Al Arab.
Okay, I'm excited.
Sobrang ganda. OMG, Mom G.
Hi.
OMG.
I want you to drink this very special coffee. It's a 24-carat gold cappuccino.
24-carat gold cappuccino. Oh my gosh, it's almost like I don't want to drink it anymore. Furne, before we drink this 24-carat gold coffee, I'd like to say thank you for taking me here to Burj Al Arab and taking me around Dubai, making this experience unforgettable, like really beating my first time in Dubai. I'll never forget it. Thank you so much, and to that, cheers. Such a pleasure to meet him because he's so down to earth, he's so shy, it's so cute. And I was so surprised because this is a person who's who's so well respected in the fashion industry, and he's met a lot of celebrities already, but he's very camera shy. He's not shy, but he's camera shy. And he's so humble, like he laughs off camera, he laughs at himself off camera. And he's really not used to being in front of the camera and asking questions. And it's just so, like, endearing to see that. No wonder why he's so successful. No wonder why he's achieved all that he's achieved. And nakaka-proud because he's a Filipino. It's a real lesson that if you stick to what you love to do and you work hard and you're sure about it, no matter how long it takes, you will get here and you will be this successful. It's very inspirational because it also took me a long time to get to where I am, but I also feel like I still have a long way to go. But it's really just nice to see that if another Filipino can make it, like, for sure sana kayanan ko rin. Ganon.
I saw Pia only in TV, and I like her because she's very natural, and she's spontaneous. She's very transparent, I think. She's real.
I definitely enjoyed my Dubai trip. It's my second time here, and the energy is still the same. It feels just as wonderful as my first time. There are a lot of things that I like about Dubai. I like the weather. A lot of people would say that mainit dito, like you wouldn't like the weather, but I enjoy it. I really like it. I love that there are a lot of Filipinos here, so it feels like home. And it's so luxurious. If I can describe Dubai in one word, it would be that.